Hello world. This guide is to help you on team coding with NetBeans IDE and GitHub repository. I'm using Linux-based Ubuntu operating system, and no matter which operating system you use, it's the same process. So let us go through its benefits. So benefits are free of cost, time saving, collaborative, and files security. So we need to perform some tasks listed as create team organization in GitHub, initialize and fetch GitHub repository, clone and pull repository, demo on coding. This part is the real part of collaborative coding, and this part will help team leader to check on who is doing what thing on his project. And this part is just for analyzing benefits, as I told before. So in this video, I'm gonna show you to create team organization in GitHub, add team members and edit privileges, and the left tasks will be done in upcoming videos. So let's go through it. Open your Firefox or other web browsers and go to github.com, and here you will need GitHub account. If you don't have, you need to sign up, and don't forget to ask your friends or team members to sign it up, because it is required. And if you already have, you can just sign in. So I'm gonna use username here. Enter your password and sign in. So yeah, follow me. Go through settings and just scroll down to organizations, and here you're gonna create new organization. Here you will give name. So name can be any string you like, any word, any alphanumeric word. So I'm gonna use demo organization. Demo.org. It's already taken. 120.12. Oh, demo.org.12. Okay. So billing email is the email for notifications. So use your own. And here is a plan. So public repositories can be seen by public. However, they cannot be edited or deleted unless your permission. It just can be downloaded by any people searching for it. And however, if you don't like it to be seen, or if you want your project to be hidden, you can go through this unlimited private repositories. So create organization. Here you can add members by using your team members username, but you can do it later. So I'm gonna just finish it. Okay, new organization is created. So we have to create a new repository here. A repository is the place where your files or course is going to be saved. So create new repositories. Here you can give repository name, my repo. So description, and here public. Okay, and you can add readme file to help your team members to give information about this project and create repository. So here you can add team members now, and this URL is required to integrate this GitHub repository on your NetBeans. So save it and add team members. So not here, go to the repository, go to organization, and here in people your team members are listed. And since we haven't added any team member till now, here is nobody except me myself. So invite member, and here enter your team member's username. So I have one. Yep. And this is the type of user owner. If you go give owner SS owner privilege or member privilege, you can read it and give invitation. So one people have been added. So ask your friend to go to email, visit their email and accept invitation. After that they will be listed here. So we have added team members, and now it's time to check some privileges. So go to settings and demo org organization, and organization privileges, members privileges. So here you can just edit allow members to create repositories. This will allow your members to create repositories, and I'm gonna uncheck this because your members can add repositories which is not necessary and I don't want it. So just don't allow and save it. And then here, if you give your members permission to just to read, they cannot edit the code. So I'm gonna provide them write access, write permission, so that they can read, write, or I mean edit. And if you give admin permission, they can also add new collaborators, and which I don't like. So you can edit these permissions and save it. And this is the warning, you should check it. Okay, it's done. So now ask your team member to check email and accept the invitation. Thank you. And next video will be showing the left part of this tutorial.